Now, this spectacular aerial view is of one of our most favorite places that we have visited over the 20 years we have spent in Florence. This is the town, the walled town of Monteriggioni. It's approximately 35 miles south of Florence and about 12 miles north of Siena. And the history is it was built in the mid-1200s, around 1215 to 1220 by the Siennese, and it was pretty much a front line in their wars with Florence. Then in the middle of the 1500s, around 1554, there was an exiled Florentine who was in charge of the garrison, and he basically just turned it over to the Medicis. And then around, I think the 1700s, Siena became under the power of Florence, and it's been pretty much the same since. But this place is just so beautiful that the circular walls, as you can see, they're probably about 2,000 feet total. And if you count, there are 14 towers and two basic portals or gates. Now, the Porta Florentina is in the lower half of this photo. You can see the little opening at the bottom here. And faces Florence. And then the Porta Roma, which is this bigger port over here, at the top in the middle of the port, that's Porta Roma. And that opens to this Piazza Roma. And the piazza itself is pretty much dominated by this Church of Santa Maria. Then inside the wall, there are houses in the main part in the main center that were pretty much owned in the old days by the wealthy merchants and the nobles and the gentry. And then there are smaller houses over onto the side with beautiful little streets, public gardens, and just so quiet and peaceful. Now, according to history, Dante Alighieri used these turrets of Monteriggioni to evoke the sight of the Ring of Giants in the Inferno, in the Divine Comedy. We have spent many times there. There's a beautiful little, small little restaurant in the center called the Restaurant Latori, and there's a Hotel Monteriggioni, which we've actually stayed at over here on the left. But again, just an incredibly beautiful spot where I ended up painting probably a dozen paintings, and I'd like to, over the years, and I'd like to begin talking about them now. This painting, La Fortezza Monteriggioni, is 36 by 48, and it's a view from inside the walls. And I must add, when we go to Monteriggioni, the first thing we do is you can get a ticket, and I think it's like €2, to walk up the top of these walls. You can walk, if you're looking at the painting in the middle, the wall goes all the way across. You can walk on those walls, and the views are spectacular, north to Florence area, south to Siena and Rome. And then you can also walk downstairs. So where we're viewing right now was a flight of stairs that walked down towards the inside of the courtyard here. And again, these colors are somewhat realistic and somewhat not realistic. Basically, the wall is very realistic. The houses you see are very, very realistic with the Siena colors and the orange of the tiles, the wall, the very deep blues and the deep greens and the deep sort of light siennas. The background is fairly realistic. The sky is fairly realistic. But again, the foreground is my artist license. These, a lot of times these trees are not quite as pretty. They're not quite as developed in the, depending on the season. This happened to be in the spring and they were starting to bloom, but I add quite a bit to the colors. In fact, when we were walking down the stairs, we were with Susan, my sister Marilyn, husband Fred, and they suggested this would be a great vista. I did not have my, I had my sketchbook, I did not have my easel, but I did a few sketches and I took a lot of photos, and this painting is the result. And as I said, once I got back to the studio, again, these very soft-colored blues and the pinks and the yellows, a little bit more of my artist license that blend with the background of the wall.
And I think if you look at the top and see the soft colors of the hills, and then the bottom, the soft colors, they sort of blend. And I'm really happy with this composition. It's one of my favorite paintings of the whole series of Monteriggioni. And it is was subsequently purchased by Brian and Brenda Johnson, who have paintings at their homes in London and Sarasota, Florida. These two paintings are the first two paintings that I did from Monteriggioni. These were done back in 2000. The top painting is a view from Porta Fiorentina, which is the gate that faces north towards Florence. And actually, I walked outside the gate and I was doing some sketches. Again, I didn't have my easel. I did have a book and I also took some photos. And there's a little interesting story. Besides the beauty of this painting, it was in the autumn, and it's the beautiful countryside of Valdessa, and it's in the Chianti region, facing, as I mentioned, Florence. So this is a typical old estate house that's not too far from the actual walled city, and the fields are just beautiful. The colors were incredibly soft. This is fairly realistic in one of my earlier Tuscan paintings, but there's an awful lot of detail. If you look at the top, we've got the fields way in the background and the hills way in the background. We got little houses way up at the top, and then the bigger house in the middle, and then the path, again, the orange and the yellows, and then the fairly realistic greens going down the path. Now, the interesting story here is when I was taking some photographs, there was an old farmer on a horse climbing up that path that we're looking at towards the gate. And when I was actually finishing this painting, which was back in an old studio I had in Sarasota, I had a studio gallery space on First Street, and my neighbor was a barber named Pedro. And I was having a problem with the composition, and Pedro came in and took one look at it and took distance, and he just said, you know, you need to paint out, try it without the rider and the horse. And I did. And I think this, it made a remarkable change to the composition because it simplified it. And one of the great rules of painting is simple is best. Anyway, this painting is 20 by 24. It was purchased by Jeff and Jen Atwood at my first show at the Wickeiser Gallery in 2000. Now, the bottom painting is a view of Porta Roma, and this is from the Piazza Roma, and the Porta Roma is looking south. This is a bigger gate. It's actually the main entrance to Monteriggioni, and the thing I like about this painting is that it was, again, this was from a photo because it was raining like hell. And it kind of stopped raining, and I really worked on the reflections of the water on the old stone in the street. And, you know, that's a tough challenge because you don't want it to look like it's a lake or a pool, but you want it to catch the reflection. And I believe I really got this perfectly. As far as the if you notice the sky and the street, they sort of blend together. And the wall, if you look at the left, there's a little stairway behind that big tree that actually gets up to the wall, and that's where you can walk around. It's about a total of about 2,000 feet, and I mentioned before, it's a big circle. This painting is 16 by 20, and it's in the collection of Joe and Mary Kay Del Priore from Ashtabula, Ohio. On this screen, we have two more paintings from Monteriggioni. The top painting is a painting from, there's a little coffee shop. When you get into Piazza Roma and you walk to the left, there's a nice little coffee shop. And if you go in, they have a little back terrace. And this painting on the top is of one of the turrets in the wall from that little terrace. I did have my sketchbook when I was working this one, and also did some photos. The thing I like best about it is really the composition, because it encompasses a lot.
you start with the tower, the wall, then there's this little house inside the little area next to the wall, the trees, and then the stone wall that separates the terrace of the cafe from the little garden there. Again, these Tuscan colors, the darks, the lights, the shades of brown, a little bit of orange, violet in the trees, and again, the typical Tuscan tile of the little house in the garden. This painting was finished at my studio in Florence. The bottom painting, it's called the Art Furniture. Mobili di Art stands for art furniture. And this is a scene that I actually did have my easel because this view is right across the street from the Hotel Monteriggioni, where we stayed one weekend back in 2005. And I thought this was just a great shot. It was early in the morning, and I just set up my easel before all the tourists came, and there was nobody on the benches. I love the simplicity. And again, this is one of these paintings that I can feel the silence. If you're there early in the morning with no tourists, it's just probably the most quiet place in the world. And again, the composition with the old bench and that great old pot there on the right with the flowers. And I did start this on a canvas there, but I actually did finish it because you can see there's a lot of detail in the bricks of the building behind it. And again, the little door and a little window on the top, just so simple, but very, very peaceful painting. This painting is in the collection of Dennis and Grass and McGillicuddy of Sarasota, Florida. And the top painting is currently for sale at our studio in Sarasota, Florida. This painting is a lot of fun. It's another one from Monteriggioni. In the background is a door it's a side entrance to the Church of Santa Maria, which is in the center of the Piazza Roma in Monteriggioni. To the left, which we can't see, is an entrance to this Armory Museum, where they have faithful reproductions of medieval and Renaissance weapons and armor. And this little wagon outside supposedly carried some form of weapon back in the 1500s. Of course, that's the story we were told. And sometimes they're true, sometimes they're not. But I had a lot of fun with this painting. The bricks in the background, in the wall, there's so many different colors there, and it just took me a long time. Again, I started it in Monteriggioni, but finished it at my Florence studio. And then there's so much color in both of these walls, and I can tell you that the wall on the left, that it's very exaggerated color. However, this wagon is very detailed and very accurate. The door, that old door, is pretty accurate, and the little brick openings in the wall. But again, there was a lot of fun with the colors, and I mean, it's a composition that, you know, I've been painting a long time, and you don't see too many articles like that that you can put into a painting and have this kind of a different, in my opinion, very different composition. The painting's 20 by 24 inches. It's in the collection of Michael Saunders and Ron Burke, who have homes in Sun Valley, Idaho, and Sarasota, Florida. Now, this painting, I could probably talk about forever. It's just a special painting. It's 36 by 48. The scene is actually I won't talk about it forever, but there's a lot in this. It's from the garden behind the Hotel Monteriggioni in the wall town of Monteriggioni. And we're looking at the hotel at the top, and to the left is the tower of the church of the steeple of Santa Maria, which is in the Piazza Roma. There's so much to this, it's almost like it's out of an art 101 with all the angles and the perspectives, but it was an awful lot of fun to paint. And again, I started it while we were there and finished. This took a long time to finish because there's so much. If you look at the wall in the foreground, it's just an incredible amount of color, and it's almost a painting in its own right, just that little section there. Then, of course, the shadows with the light and the sun in the shade,
and the sun reflecting on the trees. You see all the little yellow spots over to the right, the sunlight, and it changes the colors from the dark blues and the soft blues to the violets towards the end, heading towards the church steeple. Then there's this nice subtle wall behind the trees, the olive trees, and the colors of the... I actually spent a lot of time on the building itself. If you take a good look at it, there's a lot of different shading. It's an old building from the 1500s, so the color is totally different in certain sections. See towards the left, upper left, there's a lot of greens, a lot of golds, the small windows. It was a tremendous amount of fun to paint this painting, and again, a lot of detail. But when the total effect, I believe, is just, I wouldn't say it's simple, but I think that it just works. It doesn't come across to be as busy as it actually was to do it, if that makes any sense. Anyway, it's a 36 by 48 inch painting. It's currently on display at Mediterranean Restaurant in Sarasota, Florida. Now, this is another one of those paintings that I could really talk about forever, but of course I won't. This is a large 60 by 72 inch canvas. The view, it's actually the first painting I did from a view from the wall at Monteriggioni. And we were walking along the wall, and I had a sketchbook, but I did not use the sketchbook because it was, you know, a little dangerous. I did, however, take many, many photos, and from the photos, I completed this painting back at my studio in Florence. Now, with all of the backgrounds, and I might add, the Tuscan towns are all, you know, they're known as the Tuscan hill towns, but they're also referred to by the valleys. This area is called the Val d'Elsa, the valley of the Elsa River, and it goes around through Tuscany. This view is actually south towards Siena from Monteriggioni. We're right next to the Porta Roma on the wall. But again, there's so much in this, and there's so much color, and there's so many trees, and I just had a lot of fun. I just titled it I Cavallini, which means the horses, because you see these two, there's a white and a brown horse in sort of the middle of the painting. And with so much activity, I thought that was kind of a fun title to give it. But again, I really had a lot of fun. The foreground is pretty accurate with the greens and the road that goes across the bottom there, and then the fields, the colors of those fields are pretty much what they are, the houses what they are. The background of the dark trees and the back and way in back, the soft velvets and the violets and the blues, they're fairly accurate. Where I started to go a little crazy with the colors is in the middle, and as you can see, starting over at the left, we got a clump of olive trees that are light blue and violet, and then I really went a little overboard with the colors right in the middle, but I mixed the yellows and the oranges, and they balance them off with the cypress trees, very, very naturally colored cypress trees. And then again, some of the soft lighting of the blues of the pine trees. But all in all, I really like the way this works out of composition. There's enough balance with the yellows. There's some yellow trees over to the right. There's a lot of balance with the cypress trees. If you follow them, they go off. They start way off on the upper left and then sort of come down, go to the right, and then come out and sort of open up a little towards the viewer in the middle. And again, the field itself, very accurate. It's an absolutely spectacular view from standing up on the wall at the Porta Roma. The painting, as I mentioned, is 60 by 72 inches, and it's currently in the collection of Ed Bennett of New York City and Sarasota, Florida. Well, now, this painting, both of these paintings are certainly colorful. This will be the last painting we discuss from the Monteriggioni series, and this one on the top was actually one of the very largest paintings I've ever done in my life. I've done probably 3 or 4 of this scale. It's 6 feet by 10 feet, 72 by 120 inches.
And it's basically another view from the top of the wall at Monteriggioni next to the left of the Porta Romana. So we are facing the Valdelsa. It's south, it's towards Siena and Rome. And the big difference between this painting and almost any other painting I've done a landscape is, and I challenge myself with this, there is no sky. So we're looking down from the top of the wall, and we're looking down at the farmhouse and all the little outhouses next to it. We are looking at the background. You'll see the quintessential cypress trees which delineate the property. But there's a field at the top of the painting, and the colors in the field match the colors at the bottom of the painting. And then, of course, the colors in the middle of the painting reflect what happens when I really loosen up and try and put colors together that I feel will actually work as a composition. So in order to do this, I want to just talk about the bottom photo and the painting on the right. It's actually the same painting, but it's 24 by 32 inches. And there was so much detail in this composition that I wanted to do the smaller painting first, which I do a lot when I work outside. I'll start a smaller painting and then finish it in the studio. Both of these paintings were finished in the studio, but the top one I did start at Monteriggioni when we were actually staying at the hotel. Now, again, this composition is pretty challenging. So when I went back to the studio in Florence, I worked on both of these, but I did finish the small one first. And then I realized that I could actually accomplish what I wanted to achieve with the bigger painting, but I had to be very, very careful. Now, I might add, this photo was actually taken at my studio in Sarasota, Florida, because what happens most of the time in Florence at the end of December, I will ship paintings back to Sarasota. In the large painting, we have to unstretch and roll up and ship it. The other painting without the frame can ship as it is. When I do get them back to the studio in Florida, I have my associate and good friend John Dowd restretch the large painting, and the first painting, as I said, came as it is. But they have to be touched up after they're shipped, and they have to be reframed. So that's what was going on in this photo. But overall, the effect that I wanted to achieve, the challenge of doing a painting without a sky, I really think works. And I love the balance between the foreground and the background. The colors are pretty much the same, probably a little stronger than real life, although the house is pretty accurate, pretty close to real life. But then again, working again with the gold and yellow in the back, and then also a little bit in the foreground, then balancing off with all the kind of wild blues and violets and the pinks and the light greens. And I actually I like it a lot. I like the way it finished, and I was very pleased with the outcome, and I'm happy with the entire series that I've been able to produce from that wonderful, beautiful town of Monteriggioni. I just wanted to add that the top painting, the large 6 by 10 foot painting, is on sale at our studio in Sarasota, Florida. The smaller painting, the 24 by 32 inch painting, has been sold by the Arthur T. Callaher Fine Art Gallery in Southampton, New York. Thank you.